everyone, Rascal here.
And Mama, welcome to our channel, Paws On Animation, and another Paws On Netflix.
Yes, today we're covering a newer anime titled Zom 100 Bucket List of the Dead.
And this comedy anime follows a young man who's been overworked at his corporate job for 3 years. And he went from excited newbie to a workaholic zombie who dreaded going to work every day, and we can see why when we watched it. Until one day, he discovers that a zombie apocalypse has already started, meaning that he never has to go back to that crap job ever again.
Yep, and he couldn't be happier. And before we start, be sure to like, subscribe, click notification button on some future podcasts, and we'll to pause videos.
Yes, and thank you for joining us today. This is one we're really excited about. I actually learned about this from a Moody on the social media site formerly known as Twitter, X, named Greenseeker. And he was posting about it, and it looked like it was fun. And I stopped looking and reading because I didn't want a lot of spoilers. And then I said, you know, we really should take a look at it. I hear and see a lot of good things about it. And all well deserved. This is a fantastic breakout for this season.
Yes.
And the lead character is voiced by none other than Zeno Robinson.
And we're like, so gosh.
He went from go to zombies.
Right.
And he's so excellent in this role, really. I mean, he's fantastic as the lead character, Akira Tendo. He is fantastic.
Yes, absolutely. He ended up being a perfect fit for the character. And now this is going to go on his list of characters that he's just spot on voicing.
Absolutely. So the genres it says it covers is comedy, horror, dystopian, and zombie. This is based on a 15-volume manga. This is the anime TV series we're covering, which up to date only has nine episodes.
Yes.
And you mentioned seeing something on X as to what's going on with it.
Yeah, apparently the whole season is actually 12 episodes, but so far only 9 have aired now, and it says that the anime is now going on indefinite hiatus, and we don't know when the other episodes will be released ever in Japan or in America to dub. So people now are stuck on episode 9, and it leaves off on a pretty big cliffhanger. So now we're just unfortunately sitting waiting when they actually return. And you won't know really until either they announce it or you see it show up one day on Netflix or Crunchyroll.
Or you get the manga and pick up where you left off in the anime.
Right.
And there's also a live action film that was released concurrently, 128 minutes on Netflix, again exclusively. This was directed by Yosuke Ishida and written by Tatsuro Mishima.
Yeah, and they didn't waste time on making a live action version of this. Like, at the same time it was released, they did not waste time.
And we definitely will be watching that. Since we can't finish the anime, we'll be watching the movie.
Right.
The anime TV series directed by Kazuki Kawago and written by Hiroshi Seiko. The manga itself was written by Haru Aso and illustrated by Kotaro Takada. I wanted to mention that because for each media form, there's someone different during the writing and the directing. So
right.
I want to give them all credit because it's different for each one.
Okay. And you never thought you would see a zombie apocalypse become a comedy. And somehow this anime pulls it off. Somehow they do. It's like it's got elements of stuff of you watch from the classic zombie movies or newer zombie movies. TWD. Shaun of the Dead. It's got a mixture of all that, but it still remains its own thing. And one of the biggest draws of it is probably the concept of it itself. Is that zombie apocalypse breaks out, and this normal guy who's been working for 3 years being miserable is actually thrilled that the zombie apocalypse started. Because that means he had to go to work. All his co-workers, majority of his co-workers and bosses became zombies. So he didn't have to go back to work. And then he started living his life and was just thrilled. Zombies didn't even really scare him for the first few episodes. He was just like, it's happy and free! It's free!
And once you watch it, you'll see why. Unfortunately, anybody in this position probably would have been thrilled too, because they were like killing this poor guy. He literally was just existing and looked like he was dying. He looked horrible. Yeah. So he was literally becoming a walking, talking zombie that probably would have ended up like one of these animes where they get reincarnated in the game or something, because
right,
they were working him literally to death.
Yeah. And the unfortunate part about that and is, like, I guess it's probably from maybe one or more experiences, because we've seen many times online where people have said, for people that work in anime when it comes to drawing and they work at the companies, some of them unfortunately are overworked and they work so many long hours that they end up sleeping at their office at the company and not go home for several days. And that is shown in the anime that, yes, there are companies, whether they work for anime or corporate or what have you, that do that. And the people don't go home, or they can't go home, because they have been given so much work that it's double, triple, quadruple shifts, and they can't leave the job or else they lose it.
And they're treated so horribly. So for people that complain in the U.S. about their jobs, you know, anything, unfortunately, on the people in Japan, where we've seen not only with mangakas, but in other industries, this literally happens. I feel bad for them. No one should be literally changed to their job and can't go home, go get in their bed, eat, sleep, and relax before starting another day.
Yeah.
It's horrible. And then you also learn that they're not paid accordingly. You think, like at least in this country, most jobs pay overtime. No, they don't get overtime. They're working these extra hours for free and they're not paying them.
Yeah, anything. Yeah, pretty much. And the bosses keep the money.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, while you get that, going to be some parts of it exaggerated, but you know within it, underneath all that and the comedy, yes, there is truth to, unfortunately, how some of these people work in Japan. Now, that being said, still, the concept itself is still hilarious, because everyone else is practically terrified for their lives because the world's ending, zombies are everywhere in Japan. We don't know about the rest of the world, but in Japan, you don't even know how it started. It's just, it starts. It's just one day, zombies showed up and everything went to heck immediately. And everyone's running scared and fearful of lies, and this guy is just happy. He's running around, outrunning the zombies, going on beer runs, driving a motorcycle, and he's just really happy. And it does eventually sink in that, you know, he's got to do something about it, but for a while, he just is, like, not a care in the world.
And there's one episode in particular I want to talk about, but before that, I want to mention the author of the manga, the author of the series, he commented that, the handling of zombie genre usually has been overused, but he was actually impressed after watching a 2018 Japanese film called One Cut of the Dead. If you've seen it, let us know in the comments below. And he said he was amazed that they took a heartwarming zombie comedy, Shunichiro Ada, and wrote it. And though the manga predated the film, he also enjoyed One Cut of the Dead, while adding that he wrote the manga without being conscious of the international market. And his style describes a little offbeat and a little silly, but his point, while telling this ridiculous story, he wants the message to be that readers and viewers can do whatever they want, like his characters do.
Right. And that is actually more upbeat moral in these animes, because sometimes we see them and they kind of got bleak outcomes, like there's nothing after this, or they got subject to this and that, so it's kind of depressing, but it's actually great to see they actually have one with a more upbeat takeaway when you watch it, because amidst all the chaos of the zombies, yeah, you do actually learn something from watching it.
He also referenced Zombieland and Z Nation as being influenced as well.
Oh, yeah.
So, quick shout out to the rest of the character voice actors. As we mentioned, Zeno Robinson is Akira. You have Abby Trott as Shizuka Mikazuki. You'll learn who she is later.
Mm-hmm.
His best friend, Kencho or Kenichiro, is voiced by Xander Mobus.
Mm-hmm.
You also have Laura Post as Beatrix Umhauser, and you have Jameson Price's Gonson Coulson. Mm-hmm. And you'll see who they are when you watch it.
Right.
One thing I really want to point out is that unlike other shows that have, you know, graphic violence and blood and so forth, it was really clever that instead of seeing red all the time, you see paintball bright neon colors.
Yeah.
See pink and green and yellow
and blue.
And you don't see red. You never see blood red. All you see are these paintball colors.
Right.
And that was another way in helping to make it look more fun and you be able to get the humor and laugh. I do believe it being red, it'd be a whole different take, no matter how humorous it is. I think it still would have been taken more of as macabre than as a funny anime. And that the paintball color scheme really makes it fun.
Right.
It does. Right. Even when the faces are falling off and arms are falling off, even when they're biting people, you're seeing these paintball colors
and your brain doesn't laughing.
Yes, and your brain doesn't register it as horror or macabre.
Right.
And another thing I want to mention before we get to the episode is usually as they do in anime, they had one intro and outro the first seven episodes, or first six episodes.
Yeah.
And then they got to the seventh episode and the intro goes Assassination Classroom.
Yes. And at first they were showing clips from the previous episode that aired, and it would change with each one you're going after. Then after it gets to the seventh one, it goes to completely new animation, and in one of the points in there, it goes from the characters dancing and lip syncing to the music, and then in the background, the zombies stop eating people and start dancing.
Yes, they're doing the lion dance or the dance like Bollywood.
You're right.
Hilarious.
And one of them even starts
looking at the camera.
Yeah, yeah. They start doing poses and stuff. They just stop eating to do that.
And it's fun. It definitely reminds you of Assassination Classroom. It's fun. And it's like, okay, you're watching a zombie movie. They're eating people.
And they keep making fun of that.
People aren't coming back and you're laughing. Yes, you're laughing. You can't help laughing.
Right.
And as Rascal mentioned, there are some serious moments in it, but they don't last long. They don't overshadow the underlying message of the anime and the fun there is in watching it. The characters are clever and witty and unique and enjoyable. And at no point do you get bored watching this.
No.
Actually, you're sitting there going, okay, I want to get to the next episode.
Right.
Let's get to the next episode. Okay. It's really a lot of fun. So one episode we really want to point out, and it's the only one we're going to really focus on, is the episode in which
Akira becomes Deku.
Yes, it is clearly MHA. No, he doesn't become Hoxha.
Right.
He becomes Deku. And he puts on this suit that's supposed to prevent divers from being bitten by sharks.
Yeah.
He puts that on. It's the same color as Deku's suit. He puts a mask on with the mouth plate that looks like Deku.
Yes.
In season 6.
Yeah.
And he has his notebook, his handy dandy notebook.
Yes.
And he's referencing like Deku.
Oh,
and he's
God.
Even using his phrases.
And yes. And one of his hip moves is him having green lightning like him. Yes. For one episode, he wanted to be a superhero as part of his bucket list. So, for one episode, he was a superhero.
And it was a great shout out to MHA. It is one of the best episodes in the season.
Right.
We gotta warn you about Kendo, though. I mean, Kencho.
Okay.
But go ahead.
Right. One other thing, they make a reference to your boy Kong Ming as well. When
yes.
you watch it, one of the characters becomes like a tactician, even has the same fan, and they show Kong Ming in the background, and it's specifically the one from the anime.
And Shizuka, the girl they meet, is actually dressed like Aiko.
Yes.
And Alice said, wait a minute, she's dressed like her. So
yes.
She got her stomach out. No, they did not. It's so witty and so clever.
Yes.
And it's just so much fun to watch. Fair warning, Kencho is always naked. He's always taking his clothes off.
Gosh.
He's got a buff body, but he's a nutcase, and he's always naked, and they have this bright flashing blur that's
allowing a camera flash.
Yes, that goes over his crotch in front, or when he turns his butt around, it's over his butt. And there's one scene where he's telling the zombies to come get him. Don't you want some of this tasty butt? And they got it flashing so you can't see anything. He takes off his clothes without even unbuttoning anything. He just rips them off in one swoop.
It's like, how are you doing that?
And it's so normal to Akira that it doesn't even faze him. I guess he's been doing this the entire life.
Right.
They've been friends for a long time. And they had lost touch with each other because of both of them working jobs they hated. And the zombie apocalypse brought them back together.
Yes, I'm not kidding. And one more thing definitely mentioned for the comedy is that there are times you don't expect some of this humor to be in. Like, is it with Akira and him, these zombies? One of the funny things is that the zombies are kind of unlike zombies. For one thing, they're super fast. Like, they can actually chase people and run. They don't just, walk and take their time and they got to get a head start. They actually keep up with the people, which is why so many of them are getting eaten. And another thing is that sometimes they have weird reactions to the people. Like what you said, when he takes off his clothes at one point, distract them, they kind of stare at him for a minute. They don't even start chasing him. Like, what the hell is he doing? And then another one when they went to a hot spring.
I was going to mention it, yes.
They went to a hot springs, and because the female side was already closed out, the males and the females had to share one, and of course the guys were excited. And when they were in it and swam all in it, nothing happened.
Peaceful and calm, and they were excited.
Right. And then when the girls were ready to get in, suddenly zombies started popping out, and they all ran away. And then they started chasing them so long, they got the zombies went and got the rope and started chasing them. Like, they didn't want to run out naked.
And they moved fast. It's not like any of the other zombie movies where they move slow or they move normally. They run fast.
Right.
They have super speed. It's crazy and it's fun. So last two things I want to point out is the series is nominated for the Eisner Award in the Best U.S. Edition of International Material, Asia, and the Best Human Publication categories in 2022.
Yes.
Which it definitely deserves. And the Mary Sue, which I guess is...
I think it's a book award.
Yes. Praise the manga's premise for making the reader care, not for Akira's quest, but instead of the fact that he does not care about the fact there are zombies in Japan and how he spends his free time.
Right.
And they compared his viewpoint of the post-apocalyptic world as compared to an optimistic view of the situation in the world during the C-19 pandemic. And Otaku USA said the series gives several positive messages, such as Kira's optimism when dealing with the chaotic world, as well as the cast in general's outlook to the current status quo. And there's so much more on it. You just got to go look online.
Yeah.
And check it out. This is one of the best anime of the season. It's right up there in the top three. If you've seen Zom 100, going to shorten the title, let us know in the comments below. Do you love it much as we do? Do you have just immense praise for Xena Robinson's portrayal as we do? Let us know what you think. If you've seen the movie, let us know as well. And if you haven't watched it, it's available on Netflix. But it's also available on Crunchyroll to watch. And so far, they haven't dubbed all the episodes. And after what's happened, we're not sure if the rest are going to get dubbed right now.
Right.
But the first six are dubbed.
Right.
And then the remaining three are... No, first seven are dubbed, and then remaining two are subbed.
Right.
You have to watch it like that.
Right.
But you owe it to yourself to watch this.
Absolutely. And if you haven't already, subscribe for updates, weekly videos, your favorite anime series, anime shows, and all things animation.
Absolutely. We appreciate you so much, and thank you for joining us for covering this. This is one of our favorites right now, and we really recommend that you watch it. If you haven't, you're going to love it. It's unlike anything you've ever seen. And if you have any Netflix anime or anime elsewhere, like on Crunchyroll or on Prime, that you would like us to cover, let us know in the comments below.
Yes. So, thank you so much for watching. I'm Mask Entertainment.
And Mom Entertainment.
Have a fantastic day.